So could you talk about what made you become a social recluse? You said you were around 11 years old?
Yeah, I just the struggle and then the trying to push through those struggles and being basically slapped in the face by my teachers or doctors or therapists.
How did they treat you? Yeah.
You know, a lot of it, I mean, I would have to really delve deep and reflect to actually give you specific answers. But a lot of it was just ignoring me. They would ignore me, or they would, when I would try to go to school and I would have a meltdown, or I wouldn't talk to anybody, they would think I was lazy, that I didn't want to be part of the school environment. When in actuality, you know, that's all I ever wanted. I just needed a little help to get there. And I didn't know how to stand up for myself. I was bullied by doctors. You know, I've been inpatient in three different psych wards, and each time I leave worse off than when I entered. And the first time I went was for 5 weeks at age 12. And those 5 weeks, man, I went there because I was suffering. I didn't want to live anymore at age 12. If I knew what suicide was back then, I probably would have contemplated it, but I didn't really know what it was back then. So I went through utter hell for 5 weeks in a psychiatric ward, and I went there for help, and I was just berated and, you know, separated from my mom when she would come to visit just because I was crying and tears of happiness to see her. They thought she was enabling me. And it was just things like that. I was struggling so much, and it seemed like the harder I tried to be part of this world, the more I struggled because no one was willing to actually see me as a person. They saw me as my behavior. And it wasn't even like I was acting out. I was just crying most of the time. But for some reason, they didn't like that. I ran into a lot of old school type of teachers and doctors where they thought I should just, you know, toughen up, you know, and that's not me. I pride myself as an adult on being authentic to my feelings. And especially with regards to mental health, I don't want to hide anything. I don't want to be pressured by society to be someone I'm not just because I struggle with my mental health. So that was very true back then too. I'm very authentic, and I would show my feelings, and a lot of them wouldn't take the time to, again, see me as a human. It wouldn't, the compassion I encountered was very lacking. I retreated back into my house. I dropped out of school in the fifth grade. No supports, no services, no IEP. And I couldn't function. That was a big thing too, is OCD. My rituals were a full-time job. Every waking hour I was on doing a ritual. And then if I didn't do that, I would become very depressed and very anxious. A lot of intrusive thoughts that were really gruesome and dramatic to think at that age. And I was also very much sedated on medicine because the doctors didn't know how to help me, so they would sedate me. So I was completely non-functional. And that's another reason I decided to, you know, stop trying. You know, it's only making things worse. I'm just going to sit at home with the only person who understands me, and that's my mom.
You've been watching Autism Knows No Borders. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Also, we'd love to hear from you, so let us know what you think in the comments section. Click here to watch this interview in its entirety. You can also find us on your favorite podcast app. Tune in each week for engaging conversations of how people across the globe are inspiring change and building community. Thanks for watching. Take care.